shortly after making landfall in late August of 2005 and causing massive destruction and death along the Gulf Coast of the United States, several prominent scientists and a host of climate alarmists began claiming that Hurricane Katrina was a product of CO2-induced global warming. In fact, some of them went so far as to suggest that the monstrous storm was moral payment for the sins of a carbon-polluting country hell-bent on maintaining its high per capita CO2 emissions via their unrepentant burning of fossil fuels. Is there any scientific truth to this claim, and how sure can we be that CO2-induced global warming had anything at all to do with Katrina or any other recent hurricane? Thanks to the findings of a new paper published in Geochemistry, Geophysics, and Geosystems, we now have an answer. Using data derived from daily newspaper accounts, private diaries, plantation diaries, journals, and letters and ship records, augmented with the North Atlantic Hurricane Database as it pertains to all Louisiana tropical cyclones up through 2007, the author developed the longest continuous tropical cyclone reconstruction conducted to date for the United States Gulf Coast. So what did the data reveal? Results of the analysis indicate that the late 1820s, early 1830s, and the late 1850s, early 1860s were the most active periods of the entire record, not the 1990s or early 2000s, as climate alarmists would have you believe. And of course, the new record clearly shows that the planet's current high levels of air temperature and CO2 concentration cannot be blamed for the 2005 Katrina catastrophe, or for any recent hurricane, as both the air's temperature and CO2 content were much lower than they are currently back in the early to mid-1800s, when tropical cyclone and hurricane activity in that region was much higher than it is now. Nevertheless, there has been scare story after scare story promulgated by scientists, politicians, and the media, claiming that CO2-induced global warming is spawning super hurricanes that are ravaging the planet. Support sound science and tell these people to quit distorting and ignoring the truth. Carbon dioxide is neither a pollutant nor a major source of global warming, but a vital resource that is essential to the well-being of humanity and nature alike. To learn more about the topic of the CO2 Truth Alert, visit us at www.co2science.org and check out hurricanes in our subject index.